Hi, welcome to Stripe. We're going to talk a little bit about old video games today. And with me is Sajid, who's going to be discussing Chrono Trigger, a massively influential game from the SNES era. So, Sajid, so you were interested in talking about this video game. What made you so interested in writing about it?
So, Chrono Trigger is possibly one of my favorite games of all time because I love everything about it. There's nothing you can say bad about the game, honestly. I just loved it. So one of the main reasons why I love this game is because one of the art director is Akira Toriyama. And Dragon Ball Z, growing up, Dragon Ball Z was it's a really big part of my childhood.
Mm-hmm. As it was for me too.
Yeah, as for a lot of people. So one of the reasons why I'm going to talk about this game is because maybe it's becoming a forgetful, it is part being a part of a forgetful era. As newer games are coming out, they're revamping the, enhancing the graphics, the story, the gameplay, everything. But have we actually forgotten games that are mostly story-based, that the story is so strong that we love it and we remember it for at least 20 more years? And Chrono Trigger actually does that. From the gameplay, the music, the art style, the characters, everything is supremely amazing. And it has really given the future, the current games that are coming out, they actually look back to the Chrono Trigger as like something that you can put on a pedestal, basically.
Yeah, it's like the gold standard.
Gold standard, basically.
Of that kind of video game, right?
Exactly.
So, two things I want to ask, right? So, Chrono Trigger is basically, at the time, two of the biggest kind of series going on was Dragon Quest and Final Fantasy. So basically, Chrono Trigger is a mixture of people from both those development teams coming together to form, like, you know, a super group kind of thing, right?
The dream team.
The dream team, yeah. Right? So what it makes that collaboration so special? What is so good about that aspect?
So in recent times, the biggest collaboration that we can see is actually not related to video games all the way. Let's say Elden Ring, like Bandai Namco, and then George R. R. Martin's writing, the way he captured the fantasy outlook and environment. So that's, you can compare that to Chrono Trigger's, when they created Chrono Trigger. You can clearly see the influences of both the timing. And Dragon Quest, I actually have a confession to make. I have never played Dragon Quest.
Ooh, okay, I have some recommendations for you.
I would actually definitely want some recommendations. But as I have played Chrono Trigger multiple times, I can actually see the love, the time actually put into this game, and how it actually became so famous, so developed, so fun to play, even after like five times, because there's so many endings, so many different ways that you can finish the game, encounter, create the characters, deal with the characters. So yeah, there's a lot you can say.
So just to kind of set up the idea of the game, you play as Chrono, who's this boy who's going to this Millennium Fair. His friend Luca has kind of made this time machine.
Yeah.
And he accidentally gets caught up in it. And then the adventure kind of spans all of time and space, going to like medieval times and then like prehistoric caveman era and then into the future where we have like advanced robotics, right? And the thing I love about Chrono Trigger, I haven't finished it, which is my confession. I'm trying to play it as you're like writing the article. But what I love about it is the ambition. And that's something that I really appreciate about JRPGs, is they really go for like out there ideas that are like fun and interesting and like unusual takes on like fantasy and science fiction that you don't usually see in like more Western media. Do you also enjoy that aspect of it, of like that time hopping like grand adventure?
So one of the biggest quirks I can say is that when you actually create a story that travels different time zones, and you go past, present, future, in most cases it is a very difficult way, and you have to create the story, like develop the story. For example, if you have seen the series Dark, it's like one of my favorite series, and they have to do a lot of things with time and how the characters are going on and about. So with the aspect of time, you can actually finish the game at the earliest as possible, or you can finish the game at the mid time, or the you can take at least like 1 hour.
Yeah, they're like different
minutes,
routes, right?
Yeah, 1 hour, 20 minutes. 120 hours, sorry. So you can take different routes, you can finish the game at any point, but the fun thing is, the more you time travel, the more you get to know about different characters, the gameplay gets more diverse, more complicated, and you actually feel for the characters. You actually realize that you yourself are Chrono trying to find the answer, what you are trying, like the different characters. For example, I never know how to spell her name, Marl or Marley.
Marley.
So
that's the issue with non-voice acted games, right?
So one of the main reasons why he time traveled is because he had to save her. But then you realize that there are bigger repercussions for their time traveling. And when they go to the future, they have to battle this huge, like disastrous monster, Levos. So they realize that there are things that are bigger than them that they have to resolve to save the future.
Yeah, so there's one really cool thing I just wanted to mention really quick before we end this. One of the things that made me really enjoy Chrono Trigger is there's an early sequence where you're at the fair and you're running around doing things, and you have the opportunity to kind of play pranks on a lot of the townspeople, right? And then later on in the game, one of the smarter things that it does is they hold a trial for Chrono, right? Yeah. And then they bring up all the stuff you pulled at during the fair. They're like, oh, look at this. He stole some guy's food. Oh, look at this. And that kind of interaction and making the player feel involved is really fun. Yeah. And that was kind of new at the time, especially for the JRPG, right? So, yeah, I think it's a really unique game and I'm excited to read your piece on it. Is there anything else you kind of want to talk about with respect to Chrono Trigger?
I actually want to know something about Dragon Quest, if you would.
Okay.
Like how the game actually is, like something to garner my interest to it.
Okay, so Dragon Quest is basically the template for the JRPG, right?
Oh, wow.
So what happened was there's a series of PC games, I believe, called Wizardry. Mm-hmm. These are like basic adaptations of the Dungeons & Dragons games. Mm-hmm. So what Yuji Horii, like the guy who made Dragon Quest, really important creator, he basically made both Japanese RPGs and Japanese adventure games. Okay. So like Phoenix Wright is a direct result of this game he made called Portopia Serial Murders, right? In the 80s, really old. So he had the idea of like, what if we added a story to these mechanics and made it easier for people to play? One of his defining kind of game design principles was everybody should be able to finish this game. You know how at the time, you know, people were playing in arcades and they would try to, you know, the machines would try to gobble up your quarters.
Yeah, yeah.
So like, you know, they were designed to be hard and challenging. But his idea was you bought this game, you can, if you work hard enough, if you just spend enough time, you'll be able to beat it. So that's why all JRPGs are about like, you know, slowly growing more powerful over time, and then you can beat anybody, right? So what makes Dragon Quest good is it starts with like, the story is the main thing. Mm-hmm. It's a fun, kind of engaging, child-friendly adventure. Mm. But what makes it really, really smart is A, the Akira Toriyama designs are great. Mm. Like, he designed all the monsters. They look amazing.
Amazing.
Right? Great designs. And so that makes the whole world charming. Mm. But what it tries to do with each new entry, even though it's kind of the same style of game, they do things to shake it up. So, for example, Dragon Quest IV, Champions of the Chosen, I believe. The subtitles are all kind of weird. But yeah, so that one is, you start off as like the hero who's going to beat everything, right? Mm-hmm. Beat the final boss. But you play only for like 5 minutes as the hero, and then you play as each of your party members, right?
Oh,
so they have their own like individual stories. And then you go through them and then they all join together to form a super party. Yeah. Right? That's Dragon Quest IV. Dragon Quest V, Hand of the Heavenly Bride, is about you as you're not the hero. The main protagonist of the game is not the hero.
Okay.
You're just a kid. You start off as a kid. Your dad is this really powerful guy and you're going around with him and he's like level 20 and you're level 1 and you're trying to like slowly grow and develop. And then what happens in the game is instead of playing this like adventure where you go to beat the bad guy, you play through this character's life, right? From childhood And you know, a lot of bad things happen, right? And then you have like a teenage phase and a childhood phase, and these different phases of life. You get, at one point you get to choose who you marry, and then you have kids, and your kid actually ends up being the hero of time, right? So like, but you're not the main guy. You're like a supporting guy. And so you're like seeing this story from the perspective of someone who's had a difficult life in this kind of fantasy universe, but it's fun. And you grow really attached to that cast because it essentially becomes your family. You marry someone, you have kids, and that's your party. And it can be different depending on who you decide to marry and stuff. So that's five. And then seven is about the world is destroyed and you're putting together, I believe, right? Journey of the, no, that's eight. So I forget, fragments of a something, right? These are all like alliterative, right? That one's about the world is already destroyed, and you're trying to kind of restore it by, you know, you find a zone. Well, let's say this is the forest zone. So you restore the forest zone, and then you go have adventures there. And then you go to the lava zone, you have adventures there, right? So it's like slowly building a world that has already been taken by the darkness, right? So that's what makes Dragon Quest special, is it changes every iteration, and it becomes a kind of new take on an old idea.
That actually sounds really interesting. I have to pick up that game.
Yeah,
definitely.
So, yeah, sorry about that whole rant. But we got carried away when we were talking about these things. So, Sajid, thank you for joining me.
Thank you.
On this discussion of Chrono Trigger. We'll be back with more soon. See you.